Developing right now, a rocky start to the arraignment of the admitted 9/11 mastermind and his co-conspirators. Khalid Sheikh Mohammed and the four other defendants refused to answer a judge's questions, and officials briefly restrained one suspect to a chair. The hearing took place at the U.S. Naval Station in Guantanamo Bay. And NBC National Investigative Correspondent Michael Isikoff is there for us. Okay, Michael, we spoke about 5 hours ago. You predicted a potential rocky start. You were not wrong. Tell us what happened.
Exactly, Alex. This has been quite a contentious morning for the arraignment of these 9/11 suspects. And just moments ago, one of the key accused plotters, Ramzi bin al-Shib, stood up in the court and started talking for the first time, saying that maybe they will kill us, maybe we will commit suicide. There have been threats against them. This is the first time any of the co-defendants here have spoken out in court, because this followed hours, a few rocky hours in which the 9/11 conspirators refused to answer any questions, defying the judge. Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, who in previous occasions has chanted Quranic verses and denounced the United States, refused to answer any of the judge's questions today. The judge got quite frustrated and said, "You do not have the right to sit silent and frustrate these proceedings." He was just trying to establish whether they accepted the lawyers that have been appointed to him. One of his lawyers got up, David Nevin, and said the reason he's taken off his earphones, refusing to listen to the even listen to the judge, is because of the torture that has been done to him. These protests and others by the lawyers and the defendants essentially have tied up this proceeding this morning in knots and got this off to a very slow and raucous start.
It certainly sounds like it. And weren't there different points, times where they would, some of the defendants dropped to their knees and begin praying, and I mean, putting on a very dramatic display.
Exactly. Ramzi bin al-Shib, who just got up and disrupted the court with that outburst, previously stood up and then dropped to his knees and started praying. Another of the co-defendants, Walid bin Attash, was in a was placed in restraints, apparently because of a dispute with guards before he came in, and his lawyer said he was in pain. That was one reason he could not participate. By and large, all of these tactics appear designed to frustrate the proceedings clearly, and also underscore what the defendants and their lawyers say is the unfairness of these proceedings in a military commission, saying that they haven't been given the right to communicate with their lawyers, that their mail is being inspected. They object to the way they're proceeding. And remember, some of the 9/11 families are sitting in the courtroom. They're also listening in on closed circuit TV in seven sites around the country, and I don't think many of them are going to be very happy watching the way this courtroom has effectively been tied up in knots this morning.
Well, once again, I think you're precisely right. All right, Michael Isikoff, many thanks.